out a second, because I feel that you're going to hear this an awful lot today, and this question, what is synergy? We've already had a couple of examples of the definition of that. I took the definition from the Cambridge Dictionary. Just notice what it said. The combined power of a group of things, but when they are working together, it is greater than the total power achieved by each working separately. Slight variations, but essentially the same thing. When we think about this in the terms of live music and this industry, we start to realise that the live industry plays a massive role. How many of you here have been to a live music event, a gig or a concert? Pretty sure I'm talking to the right crowd there. Interestingly, £25 billion is generated annually through live music. A staggering figure. Something that's just very, very high level. When we bring that a little bit closer to home and look at live music here in the UK, we see that £1.1 billion is generated towards the UK economy. A total of 27.7 million people attended live music or concert events in 2015. We can see the rise of festivals. There are many of them not too far from here that have recently come back. 3.7 million individuals attending. So we start to see that live music really does have an important role in today's society. Here in London, 8.4 million people in 2015 attended a live music event. And what's encouraging is that there are a number, quite a large number, 25,000 plus full-time jobs that are being sustained by this industry. So that's all the high-level data. I'm not going to bore you too much with many more figures. I couldn't come to Tottenham and speak to you guys without mentioning a few of what I would basically class as your local heroes, some of your local musicians. Now, I apologize if there's any musicians that I have forgotten. Obviously, we are limited for time, and so when I was doing a little bit of research, these were just four that for me stood out. For those of you that maybe don't recognize, we've got the lady Adele there. In the middle, moving across, we've got Skepta. On the far right, we've got Lamar, and just at the bottom here, the rapper Chipmunk. Now, what's quite interesting about each of these four individuals is that they've all had a level of success, some, you know, worldwide, some global superstars, but each of them have something in common. And I'd just like to break down, essentially, what has helped each of these individuals in their journey. As I'm sure you can guess, the one thing that they all have in common is there's an element of synergy. So what is it then that, for instance, takes a lady from Tottenham, just an average musician, like everybody else who has a dream, to playing to 60,000 fans at a stadium in Brisbane in Australia just a few weeks ago? What is it about Joseph Adenuga, aka Skepta, that takes him from being just a local rapper to someone now who is essentially at the top of his game in the UK grime scene, and is also essentially a poster boy for all things that are happening at the UK level? Not only that, he also won the best album, Mercury Prize, just at the end of last year. He also then collaborates with one of the biggest rappers on the world scene at the moment, Drake. And not only does the collaboration, but signs him to his independent, boy better known label. What is it that takes young, as he was at the time, Jamal Fife, aka the rapper Chipmunk, just from being a young boy in a playground, spitting bars like every other MC wanted to young teenagers of the UK music industry that we've seen in recent times. And as we mentioned with the other example, Lamar, one of the early examples of someone that went on a reality TV show wanting to get fame, to be known across the world, but then eventually went on to sell millions and millions of albums. Aside from the fact that they're all incredibly talented, all very hardworking, and have extremely hard work ethic, the one thing that's consistent throughout all of their stories is synergy. And what I'd like to do just for a few moments is just to break down the synergy, or see how synergy has a role in each of their stories. Now in live music, there's essentially what's called a value chain. Various components, individuals, that work essentially to create something much larger. At the center of this, you obviously have the artist. They are the one that creates the music. Whether that be in their bedroom or their home studio, whatever their setup is, they are essentially the ones that create what we all love to listen to or go and see live. But even at that level, that's where you start to see the introduction of synergy. Imagine the artist that just has maybe the song or, you know, something that they want to create and put out to the world. Just think of some of the other individuals that are involved in getting it to that point. What about the songwriters, the producers, the composers, the sound engineers that work in the studio just to make sure that everything sounds the way that it should, the DJs that maybe they work with? All of these individuals play such an important role in getting what the artist dreams of into a final product. So already we can start to see that if the artists were just to work on their own and not involve any of these elements, their dream could just stay as a dream. However, with all of these parts, that's where the reality starts to come in. The next part of this value chain comes down to the artist manager. Now this person essentially is in charge of managing that artist's career and every aspect of that career. Now this person has a very key role because they have to act effectively as the liaison, the middleman between lots of different entities, whether that be a record label that want to sign the artist or maybe already have, maybe a music publisher that wants to use their music in a certain way. It might be an agent that wants them to get as big as they can be and tour the world very soon. It could also be that it's for promoters like myself. We're the ones that want to put on these concerts, so obviously we're looking for the very best talent. The artist manager plays an important role in liaising with us. Obviously in an age where it's often spoken about, where music sales are not as high as they used to be, it's very important that an artist makes money outside of music. You'll see many artists today fronting campaigns that have brand partnerships or corporate sponsorship deals, where they would effectively be the face of a particular brand or a campaign. Again, the artist manager plays such a key role in deciding what is the right fit for his or her artist. Essentially, you could say that the artist manager is responsible for coming up with the plan that will take the artist from that bedroom with a little bit of music to suddenly being someone that hopefully will be known worldwide. The chain continues because once an artist starts to reach a certain level in their career, they may introduce an agent. Now this person manages effectively their live career, helping them to decide when and where they should be playing, how they should do this, how they should market themselves. And this is again such a key role, because imagine that you've got an artist that's on a steady trajectory, you know, making progress, making a bit of a name for themselves, has developed a nice fan base, everything seems to be going well, and then maybe just just out of wanting to hurry the process along a little bit more, they decide to put that artist into too big a venue. That could always be disastrous to that artist's career. Imagine the headlines when an artist plays to a half-empty venue just because they were a little ahead of the curve, not quite ready maybe to play that. So sometimes you'll see what's quite interesting is that an artist will effectively, whilst they may have the fan base, they may choose to underplay. The agent may sit down with the manager and the artist and say, well, let's play just some slightly smaller venues. Let's ensure that we sell those out first, and then that gives us the collateral to come back next time and play in bigger venues. A really, really valuable role. Again, synergy in action. Then comes the promoters, ones like myself. They call us the risk takers. Before I was a promoter, I had hair. It can be a very difficult and challenging role. We're the individuals that we spot the talent, we think we've got an eye for talent, we think we know what can sell, and so it's our role then to essentially negotiate with the agent, try and do a deal that way. We'll then speak to the venue, we'll hire the venue, we'll decide the ticket price, we'll do all the marketing, and essentially what we're hoping is that we sell enough tickets to cover the costs, and as is always the case, you would want to make a profit. Again, even within a promotions team, there has to be synergy. Imagine someone like myself who works specifically with the marketing and the PR campaigns and trying to sell tickets, not knowing which artists we've even got on the bill, or not knowing how big the venue is, or not even knowing what the daily ticket count may be. Again, the team will be a lot wider, a lot larger, and that way, through good communication, again, we can see good synergy in action. Now, obviously, there are lots and lots of different people that play a role in getting an artist to the point of playing live. Some of the others mentioned here, we think about the venue operators, the ticket operators. A key role is the radio DJs. Today, they are effectively known as the tastemakers, or the people that can essentially make or break an artist's career just by putting them on a playlist and putting that out to the wider world. Again, in the day of the age of the internet, we're seeing a lot of online radio stations. We're seeing things that, you know, where you've got a station that may be seen globally, and people can tune into a station anywhere in the world and listen to music. Again, the opportunities for an artist in helping them to develop their fan base are just huge. When it comes to the actual events and the playing live, all the moving cogs behind the scenes, again, a case where you see synergy in action. I'm today personally working on a concert this evening, and before I'd even got out of bed today, we'd already had all of the contractors, the sound, the lighting, the audio people at the venue already setting up. When we turn up at the concerts, just as consumers, everything just looks like it's there in place. But there's obviously lots of hard work that has gone into it. So these are all of the various parts of this value chain. As we take a step back each way, you can see that there has to be synergy in all of these areas. No one individual in any of these cases, you could say, is more important than the other. Yes, without the artist, we wouldn't have the live music, but then maybe without some of these other elements, there'd be no artist at all. And I'm glad that when I asked the question around who had been to a live music event, a gig or a concert, that every single one of you in the room put your hands up. Because the key part of that value chain is the fan. You could say that it's the most important part of that chain. Without the fans, who would the artist play to? Who would buy or stream their music? Who'd buy their merchandise? Who would buy those concert tickets? Without the fans, the artist would just be stuck in their bedroom, stuck in their home studio, their dream, very much Spain as a dream. So when we think about the role that live music has in all of our lives, we think that there's a certain amount of synergy that has gone into this. Some of it very visible. Often we can't see all of those moving parts. So as we go away today, maybe now, when you go to your next gig or your next concert, whatever it is that you enjoy doing, maybe you'll just see that in a slightly different light. Maybe you'll be analysing, I wonder how involved the tech person was here. I wonder who this artist's agent is. I wonder how it is that they were able to get from playing in a small room to suddenly playing something quite large. And I'd just like to conclude by just mentioning just two very specific examples that I've seen in recent times that really, I think, demonstrate that this isn't just something that happens by mere chance. Two artists in particular that come to mind. Firstly, the Grime MC, Stormzy. Many of you may have heard of him. At the moment, again, one of those artists that's at the top of his game recently had a number one album. And this is just someone that's only a couple of years, effectively, into his music career. But what's quite interesting is that not only does he have the ability to get a number one album, but when you look behind the scenes at his live music, this is an individual that very much has had to do and work the scene in order to get to where he is today. His most recent tour that he's just about to start sold 40,000 tickets in just one day alone. This, as we say, an artist that's at the very start of his career. The second example, now we're talking a lot bigger, on a global level, Ed Sheeran. 6 years ago, he was mainly playing just to a small room. In fact, I remember seeing Ed Sheeran play to 20 or 30 people in the basement of a pub somewhere in Bracknell. Believe it or not, whilst on that stage there were people talking in the background and he was having to tell them to be quiet and, if they wanted to talk, to leave the room. When he made that request, certain individuals did leave the room. Imagine now that same individual that has the ability to sell out 240,000 tickets play at Wembley Stadium. Again, couldn't have done it on his own. All of those parts that we've looked at today definitely contributed to everything that has happened. So as I say, maybe now when we go to our concerts, our gigs, our live events, our festivals, all of these different things, we'll now be able to just think that even someone that may be a local musician, a local artist, someone that just has that dream, through the use of synergy, those dreams really are able to be turned into reality.